Now, the artist and realism. Art is something where you see the picture and try to portray the picture, but it doesn't be real. But after the Greek people have carefully observed that things, the artists have turned into so talented and they became to imagine the Greek and the Roman literature so immensely and so deeply that they started to make the pictures as it is they look in reality. So that is the approach of realistic approach. So the artist towards the realism, it just appears, how does it appear in real, in picture, whether man is standing or woman is standing. The same way they used to portray the pictures, they used to make the statues, they used to make the sculptures. All these has brought the extraordinary talent of the Greek people. This was born in light when 1416, when Donatello, life like statues, he made the statues which are just like people who are standing there. So that has created the new strategies for us. And these people, the artists especially, moved to laboratories. Andreas Vesalius was the first man to move to library and to study the human biography and the anatomy of the human structure. How does a body look? How does it look inside? How does the body parts look? So that for that they can maintain a perfect picture of the human beings and they can portray them realistically. And we have the world famous painter, that is Leonardo da Vinci, the human anatomy. He knows the subjects of human anatomy. He knows the subject of geography, to know the trigonometric talents, qualifications of mathematical calculations to make the pictures to highlight and low and low it. Oil paintings were used. The three-dimensional paintings were used. His picture of the Mona Lisa, even today it's very famous, where he portrays the picture exactly like someone is looking at us. And we have the Last Supper, which is also an extraordinary painting, world famous paintings. These all are done because of their multi-talented nature, and they have observed the picture so clearly that it has brought a change in the outlook of it. And next, we have the support from the church, especially from the Roman Catholic community. And we have the artists called Michelangelo and Raphael, who have done a fantastic job. And Leonardo da Vinci has to write under his signature that he is the disciple of experiment. So he would love to do experiments. He would learn by doing experiments. This all reveals the facts, their culture and dedication and their passion towards the drawing and the culture of painting has revealed the nature of the Greek art and Italian outlook. Now, when we look at the architecture, how it has developed, the Pope of Rome started to encourage the people in the later part of the 14th century to make them to study about the ruins of the Roman style and culture, where the Roman style early precedes that they have tall pillars, arches and domes. This is the dominant symbol of the constructions of the Rome. So they have studied it very clearly and they have observed the clear cut idea of what is the Roman culture. From the past, they have learned it and they have to start to rebuild the culture. And now it has become a change in the trend that earlier these people were employed by the churches and paid by the churches, but now they are famous by their art and artistic nature. Those people are, one is famous, one is Michelangelo, who is famous for his Sistine Chapel painting and who made a sculpture called the Pietà, which is an extraordinary sculpture. And he also was famous for his domes, which he has designed for the St. Peter's Basilica at Rome, which is an extraordinary building. Even today we have the same dome culture there. And we also have the artist called Filippo Brunelleschi. He has made the Duomo of Florence, where he started his life as a sculptor. He copied many of the artistic views of the Roman style and he created his own impression in the place of Florence. So like this, the artists have made their appeal to be realistic by studying various subjects, various parts, and they brought the approach to be the realistic nature, and the art and architecture has flourished. Today also we have the great significance for the art of Italian art and architecture. Now, the invention of a machine which has created a tremendous changes in the human outlook. The information started to pass on to various corners of the world and it can reach to millions of people. That is the real correct information. What you have said expecting is the right one. That is the printing press. The printing press was invented in 1455, where 150 copies of the Bible was made by Johannes Gutenberg, who was actually a monk who has studied the Bible very carefully and made the printing done very clearly, and so that Now the information started to reach to the millions of corners of the people, and everybody had to learn about the Bible, understand the Bible. Nowadays, the modern days, the printing has become a very key financial factor where it can connect to millions of people. The newspaper, once the news gets spread in the newspaper, it reaches to millions and tens of millions of people where it cannot be stopped once. So the connectivity of spreading of the news was first invented by John Gutenberg, the printing press. The latest developments of the human mankind was the new concept of human beings. The new concept of human beings was that earlier the human beings has to develop the humanistic approach where they started to consider that everybody is human and they realize the humanistic nature which we have discussed earlier. But now they started to have the other new trends was that they need wealth, we need power, we need the glory, we need the bodily pleasures. So these all are started to be added for them, and now they need politeness, the way they dress, the way they speak, the way they communicate with each other. They decided that nowadays the human beings are multi-talented and multifaceted and not at all restricted themselves to any particular strength of any of their talents. Now, Niccolo Machiavelli has written the book of The Spirit of Laws, where he clearly studies that he did not give any guidelines to any rulers like how to rule and what to rule, but he brings out the corner of the human beings that human beings are almost always are self-interested and self-motivated, not towards the benefit of the nature or not towards the benefit of the kingdom, but they are self-interested and they need to get benefits more. This fact made him to be top on the ruling administration because he brought the hidden nature of the human beings outside, which is very rare. He studied very carefully the human beings, he reached to the human beings, he got connected and he reached the outlook, and he made the book of The Spirit of Laws, which today has, even today it's considered as valid, even it was written in the 14th century, which means for us, how to rule was nothing but the people, to understand the people clearly. This is a very economically very good book, and regarding to the issue of understanding the administration or politics, this is a fantastic book. Why I mentioned it is economically very good book, because even today most of the influential politicians go through this book who are successful in administering or manufacturing the political affairs. Next, moving on to the aspirations of the woman. The women in the olden days are restricted to very few decisions. Like even though they used to pay a huge amount of dowry, which will be invested in the business of the husband, but they have very little say on the business, or sometimes it was null. And in case they could not pay the arrange of the dowry amount, most of the women are sent to lead a nun's life where they are not eligible to get married. So there are very few people who are eligible to talk something in front of their husbands or do help some kind of business helps for the husbands. Like the shopkeepers or the businessmen's wives used to assist them when they are addressing the shop, or the business people when the husbands are out of the place. Like this, we have very few people, and in case convert situation where the husband dies or pass away, then only the widow comes out and takes over the responsibility of the business. Like this, we have the various drawbacks in the outlook of the women during that period of time. But later we have the voice of Venetian Cassandra Fedel, who was very fluent in the Greek and Latin language, who was called by the University of Padua for her orientations, raised her voice very clearly and made it very clear statement that why are women considered inferior than to the men? Women also have to be given the economical freedom and the properties to prove that their identity, and then we can prove the talent of the woman equal to the power of men. And then we have Marchesta of Mantua, who ruled the state of Isabella, where when husband was out of the place, and she was known for her brilliancy of ruling, because women also proved to be right at some times, because women are not given chance at any point of time, so we can't guess whether they are right or wrong. So once if the chances are provided for them, obviously they can prove to a maximum extent whether it is right or wrong. So that is a point which was made by Venetian Cassandra Fedel, that women also has to be given freedom of economic equality and the properties so that they can create their own identity.